Hello and welcome to episode 6 of Learn English with Photos. My name is Geoffrey Hill and in this lesson I'm going to be presenting vocabulary for different shops and the things they sell. In the final part of the lesson, you'll have the opportunity to answer some questions about shops and shopping. Okay, let's begin. I've tried to group the shops into categories according to the word pattern they follow. To start, there are all the shops which end in apostrophe S. For example, newsagents. Now, a newsagent is a person who sells newspapers and magazines. You could use the term newsagent's shop, but this is usually shortened to newsagents. So you would say, for example, I'm just going to the newsagents to buy the Daily Mail. As the name suggests, a tobacconist's is the shop where a tobacconist sells tobacco products, such as cigarettes and cigars. However, many tobacconists in the UK also sell things like sweets, newspapers and magazines. A grocer's is a small shop which sells foodstuffs and other household supplies. The things you buy there are called groceries. A greengrocer's is a shop selling fruit and vegetables. So the man in the picture is, yes, a greengrocer. A florist's is a shop which sells flowers and plants. The expression flower shop is also commonly used. If you want to buy meat, you go to the butcher's. Note that the sign doesn't have an apostrophe. This could just be a mistake, or perhaps there's more than one shop. A fishmonger's is a shop selling fish and seafood. I hope that fish is fresh. The baker's or bakery is where you go to buy bread and cakes. I love the smell of fresh bread, don't you? If you've got a sweet tooth, you'll enjoy going to the confectioner's where they sell sweets and chocolate, or candy if you're American. The stationer's is a shop which sells stationery, that is to say the things you need to write such as paper, envelopes, pens, etc. Most stationers also sell a range of office supplies as well. A jeweler's sells jewellery, that's rings, necklaces, bracelets, etc. and watches. Note that in American English the word jeweler only has one L. The woman cutting the hair in the picture is a hairdresser and she works at a hairdresser's or hair salon. If you need to get your eyes tested or buy a pair of glasses, you can go to the optician's. The chemist's or pharmacy is where you go to get medicines, but most chemists sell toiletries and beauty products as well. Boots is the most famous chemist in Britain. Note that in America they prefer the term drugstore. These days more and more people book their holiday online, but some still prefer the personal touch you get at the travel agents or travel agency. The final apostrophe S shop is the dry cleaners. This is where clothes are cleaned with a liquid chemical rather than with water. Another category of terms for shops are those which contain the word shop. Quite often the first word will be the thing sold in the shop followed by the word shop. So for example, we have toy shop, pet shop, clothes shop, shoe shop, computer shop, sweet shop, newspaper shop, and so on. Usually there are two words, but bookshop is an exception, as it is usually written as one word. A couple of other kinds of shop are the betting shop, where people go to bet on something, such as a horse race, and the charity shop, which sells used or second-hand goods cheaply and gives its profits to charity. Charity shops are very common in Britain, and you'll often find several in the same high street. Now let's look at some other types of shops and services you find in most towns. A beauty salon or beauty parlour is a place where women can go to have beauty treatments, for example, or to have their hair, nails or makeup done. A post office is a place where you can buy stamps and post letters or packages. An off-licence is a shop which sells beer, wine and other alcoholic drinks. A cafe is a place where you can buy drinks, simple meals and snacks. Note that the drink is coffee. A delicatessen, sometimes shortened to deli, is a shop that sells high quality cheeses, salads and cooked meats. Now let's look at a few terms which include the word store. In British English, store is mainly used to refer to a large shop selling a variety of goods. But in American English, a store can be any size of a shop. A hardware store is a shop which sells articles for the house and garden, such as tools, nails, pots and pans, etc. A DIY store sells equipment for making and repairing things in the home. DIY stands for do it yourself. A department store is a large shop that is divided into separate departments, each selling different goods. The most famous department store in the UK is Harrods in London. A superstore is a very large store, usually situated on the outskirts of a town, perhaps in a retail park. To finish, we're going to look at a few terms containing the word market. The basic meaning of market is a place where people buy and sell goods. So you can have an indoor market or covered market, or an outdoor market or street market. Then there's the supermarket, which is a large shop that sells all kinds of food and household goods. In the UK, the biggest supermarket chains are Tesco, Sainsbury's, Asda and Morrisons, which are sometimes known as the Big Four. A hypermarket is a very large supermarket, usually located outside of town. In the next part of the lesson, I'm going to show you each picture again, without the caption, and see if you can name the shop. I'll then show you the caption and say each word twice, giving you time to repeat it after me. Newsagents. Newsagents. Tobacconists. Tobacconists. Grocers. Grocers. Greengrocers. Greengrocers. Florists. Florists. Butchers. Butchers. Fishmongers. Fishmongers. Bakers. Bakers. Confectioners. Confectioners. Stationers. Stationers. Jewelers. Jewelers. Hairdressers. Hairdressers. Opticians. Opticians. Chemists. Chemists. Travel agents. Travel agents. Dry cleaners. Dry cleaners. Toy shop. Toy shop. Bookshop. Bookshop. Charity shop. Charity shop. Betting shop. Betting shop. Beauty salon. Beauty salon. Post office. Post office. off-license, off-license. Cafe, cafe. Delicatessen, delicatessen. Hardware store, hardware store. DIY store, DIY store. Department store, department store. Superstore, superstore. Indoor market, indoor market. Outdoor market, outdoor market. Supermarket, supermarket. Hypermarket, hypermarket. Right, that's enough vocabulary. Let's move on to the last part of the lesson where you get to do some speaking. I'm going to ask you a series of questions relating to shops and shopping. I suggest you pause the video to give yourself time to answer. And don't just reply with yes or no. Try to make your answers as detailed as possible. Okay, let's begin. Question 1. How do you feel about shopping? Do you enjoy it or hate it? Question 2. Which do you prefer, large stores or small stores, and why? Question 3. What's your favourite shop? Question 4. What was the last expensive thing you bought for yourself? Where did you buy it? Question 5. When you go shopping for food, do you read the labels? Question 6. Do you ever buy second-hand goods? Question 7. When you want to buy something, do you shop around and go to different stores to compare prices? Question 8. What's your hometown like for shopping? Question 9. What's your experience of buying things on the internet? Question 10. How do you think shopping will evolve in the next 10 to 20 years? Okay, that's the end of the lesson. I hope you found it useful. If so, watch out for the next episode of Learn English with Photos.